Your Excellency, the Minister of Education of Jordan, Dr. Mohammed Al-Wahsh, Your Excellencies, dear ladies and gentlemen, respected guests, God's blessings be bestowed upon you on the occasion of the conduction of this Arab Educational Summit or Education Summit, and on behalf of the Minister of Higher Education and Scientific Research in Iraq, we bless those efforts of yours exerted in bringing forth together this crowd that opens the door before international and Arab coordination and cooperation to derive at the proper cadre and qualified output that will match the market needs and the Arab integration in all sectors. Represented by the ministries of education, in addition to their responsibilities in producing and disperse knowledge and scientific research culture. Here, we would like to say that enhanced higher education institutes and rebuilding it and further developing it is among the priorities of the Iraqi government, given the importance of those institutes as responsible for the development of the human capital. Dear ladies and gentlemen, because of the circumstances Iraq has been going through in the last decades, it retreated education-wise on qualitative and quantitative levels. Because the damage affected higher education institutes in terms of the infrastructure, building, laboratories, and the brain drain, in addition to losing qualifications because the militarization of the countries, wars, and sanctions that have adversely affected on the performance levels. And in order to be able to have the appropriate output, the ministry put a strategy for enhancement of quality based on two main components or goals. One, the rehabilitation and development of universities, institutions, and other departments of the ministries, whether infrastructure or research centers that belong to it, in order to increase capacity on vertical and horizontal levels by enhancing and developing the level of the services that are being offered to the student and the educational cadre, in addition to the establishment of new universities and research centers all over the governorates of Iraq. The second goal is to enhance the academic realities, enhancement of the performance of the teaching staff by caring for all sciences and adoption of the most up-to-date technologies, in addition to the level of the research and qualifications of the graduates theoretically and application-wise, in order to meet the demands of the governmental institutes, market in all levels and specialization. In order to realize the two above goals, the ministry started to put forth a strategy based on priorities towards establishment of projects so that it bases itself on two basic methodologies in funding those projects, first of which is those funded by the general budget of the country. By the general budget with its both operational investment parts. Secondly, opening investment horizons before the private sector in order to invest in higher education. And our ministry believes that going forth into those paths in a parallel fashion will save time in order to reach those two set goals. The ministry at the moment has 19 universities that are dispersed over the Republic of Iraq, void of Kurdistan. i.e. without. And in addition to the technological and computerization center and the medical center of Iraq, of specialized medical national center, those institutions harbor, among them, more than 64 medicinal faculty, 36 engineering, and 74 in education applied sciences, and 25 in agriculture, veterinary, and more than 40 college that report back to the technical vocational, in addition to dispersed scientific centers and a teaching cadre that has more than 35,000 teachers and lecturers and 54,000 employees and staff. Therefore, it is important for us to avail the necessary resources to continue input of resources towards that via the general budget, so that operational budget was targeting towards pumping into those institutions, in addition to the investment aspect that cares for the infrastructure, in addition to the establishment of new universities, colleges, and research centers using the most up-to-date technology, so that allocations in order to develop the higher education institutes via the general investment budget in 2009, more than $2 billion. And this has increased to reach in 2013 to more than $10 billion. And this included all the projects that are apt to work on the development of the higher educational path in Iraq in terms of qualitative development via the establishment and the rehabilitation of the internal sections and divisions and establishment of infrastructure, in addition to the equipment of all research units and the centers and the establishment of lecturing halls, in addition to housing units that are specific for the teaching staff, in addition to the equipping, special equipment for laboratories and learning workshops and qualitative advancement via new research centers, so that this component included the establishment of 8 universities and university cities that are comprehensive, in addition to 19 advanced research centers dispersed all over the geographical expanse of Iraq as follows. The Nineveh General University, and in 3 places, please put off your mobiles. There is also a place where we are building universities in order to make sure all the segments of the communities and minorities of Iraq are included, so that this university takes more than 25,000 students, males and females. The special university is very specialized. That uses the natural resources in order to have a special graduates for the oil sector, and the Ibn Sina Medical University in Baghdad, that will represent a very specialized university with a university hospital that will take more than 600 beds, in addition to many educational teaching and research centers, medicinal, that is, in addition to Babel Institute, the green university, which is friendly to the environment, specialized in pure sciences and sustainability, so that it takes more than 25 students in capacity. Somer Agricultural University in Dakar, the district of Rifa'i. And it is a very specialized one in veterinary and agriculture that guarantees the utilization of the natural resources of the area, so that it has a capacity to take more than 12,000 students, males and females. Ibn Hayyan Medical University, that specialized in pharmaceutical and medicinal sciences, so that it falls in the governorate of Najaf, taking more than 10,000 students. Samira General University falls at the Salah Governorate, taking more than 19,000 students, and General Fallujah University. And and it takes all the laboratories. And of course, it can take more than 20,000 students in capacity. And in general, our ministry is working on a methodology to strategic orientation so that it is directed towards hospitals, equipment, laboratories, and many other supportive organizations supported by international partners and specialized partners that had already applied such projects in other countries and have the experience and the aspects we also look upon by our ministry is the qualification of the higher education cadre so that it included 40,000 scholarships in all levels from the bachelor degree to the master's to the PhD outside Iraq. And it has also, as for the scientific aspect, we have more than $800 million in order to support the current existing research centers and in order to budget more than 700 research projects currently. And the private sector has been actively participating through its private colleges that are dispersed all over Iraq, in all the governorates, in all humanitarian and scientific specializations, so that the number of private colleges and universities falling under the Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research is to 42 colleges and universities. Remember, there are those that are reporting to other ministries or other establishments or institutions. And in order to not to overburden the general budget and in order to cater for increased job opportunities and because we believe in investment as a main pillar in the development of countries, the ministry has started to open doors of investment in higher education before for internal and external investors in all specializations that will save time and reach higher levels towards meeting the goals of the ministry. Therefore, our ministry has announced projects open for investment covering all our universities and centers inside the ministry, in addition to opening the door before the investment to come forth with their own suggestions and propositions of projects that will enhance this path, among which are housing investments, research specialized centers, and sports, swim halls, and other investments, universities, so that there will be twinning with international universities and all those adopt methodologies that are theoretical and practical in nature, serving the demand of the market and other needs. In addition to this ongoing investment and the establishment of a new university and colleges, we have to train on all levels of specialization, scientific specialization. Finally, all those good efforts compel us to call upon all participating and contracting companies that are fulfilling the ministry's projects, whether it's on design, construction, and we are also communicating with the equipping companies for scientific equipment to participate in equipping the scientific and research units. We also call upon all the companies and investments to enter into investment in the higher education sector via the open investment opportunities that are being announced on our internet page so that our ministry will avail all possible services to the investors via or under the auspices of our investment laws. At the end, I thank the Minister of Education in Jordan, Dr. Mohammed Al-Wahsh, and I thank the Arab Brains and its General Director General, Mr. John, for so kind of organizing, wishing you all the success forever development, and wishing Jordan, nation and government, peace, and thank you very much. Peace be upon you.